Hello, so my name's Catherine from the Singer Sewing Centre in Whitley Bay. Today we've just got in the new Disney Brother machine, which is the M280D. So what we thought was, now we've opened it, we'll show you what you get in the box. So first things, you get the sewing machine, which you can see is very nice and stylish. And then you have the embroidery unit, and it also comes with a little scissor, sort of little sewing kit. So you get like scissors, you get three spool caps, so you get a large, a medium and a small. You also get twin needle, you get a little lint brush, you get a few different needles, you get spool net, you get seam ripper, you also get an extra spool pin, so that's obviously when you use your twin needle. You get, and there's a couple of the different screwdrivers in there as well. And then you've got your main screwdriver, which you would use to change your feet. And then you have these feet that come with it. So you get a little pouch as well. So you've got the embroidery foot, you have the blind hem foot, you have the button sewing foot, you've got the over edging foot, the zipper foot, the fancy stitch foot, and the buttonhole foot. It also comes with four pre-wound bobbins, which have bobbin fill on them. They also come with the new clips, which is a new feature, so it doesn't unravel. You would just take those clips off when you put them in the machine. And then it comes with a 10 by 10 centimetre embroidery hoop. That's the one it comes with. And then you've also got the little grid, which you use to centre your designs in. Embroidery unit. Then you also have a few manuals. So you've got the operation manual, so that would be used for your embroidery and sewing side of it. So you've got all sorts of different tips and hints in there. Then you have the Disney design guide, so that has all the Disney designs in it, and it tells you what colours you need, tells you how long it takes, and also tells you how big it is. Then you've got the embroidery design guide for all your other designs that aren't the Disney ones. Again, same thing, tells you what size, what colours you need, and how long it takes. Then you also have this little leaflet, so it tells you what comes within the box. And then it also has a quick reference guide. So again, that's just really quick little hints and tips, how to thread the machine, how to put fabric in your hoop, even how to switch it on. And then you also have these little grids. So these are for when you can make your own stitches on this machine as well. So obviously you can pinpoint your little points on there. So you're better off when you're on the sewing machine to make your own. So that's everything that you get in the box when you open it. Okay, so now we've turned on the machine, we'll start with the sewing side of it. So you can see you've got all your different stitches here. You've got your thread cutter, your sort of secure end point. So I'll go through these few stitches. You've also got your different sections. So you've got your different over edging, few different ones there. Your buttonholes, it does have the same amount of buttonholes as the 955, I believe. This is a very similar machine to the 955. But it is bigger in certain areas and has got a lot more designs on it. Plus it has a colour screen, which the 955 doesn't. It's a lot clearer as well. Got a few other different ones. Cross stitch, which it does really well. A few others. And you've got a few different alphabets, different letters there. So these are just for your sewing side of it. There is more on the embroidery side. Then you've got make your own stitch, which is really simple to use. So you just click set and then move it to the next point that you want. And you can also delete points, you can test it. You've got memory there. There's all sorts of different options on there. And then another main point for the machine is that these feet are a lot longer than the normal Brother machines. So what that means is if you're going over, say, a thick hem or something like that, where the foot's going to go over the fabric, it starts doing that a lot sooner. So it's a lot easier for it to glide over things like that. The feed dogs are a lot longer as well, so that matches obviously the foot. You've got the standard things of, you've got the speed control, you've got the thread cutter, the needle up and down button, you've got the reverse button, start and stop button, you've got a fully adjustable tension dial, and your straightforward threading on the top, which I'll go through. And then you've also got the embroidery side, the embroidery design side of it. So the embroidery designs you've got is, we'll start with the Disney ones. So these are your six sections. So you've got Mickey, Minnie, Donald, Daffy Duck, a few combinations, a few really cute ones. Some more Mickey and Minnie, some of the little things you can do there. Winnie the Pooh, you've got the princesses, Alice in Wonderland, Tinkerbell, Frozen. Then you've got a little boys section as well. So you've got Cars, Toy Story, Monsters Inc. and Finding Nemo. And then you've got the sort of other embroidery designs, which are like little cats, dogs, a few Easter ones, geometric and sort of quilting ones. Then you've got some other little florally designs, little kid ones, Halloween, Christmas. And then you've got your decorative fonts. So again, you've got quite a few of those. And then you've got all these different fonts. So these are the ones you can make bigger and move on to your designs, because you can combine designs on this one, embroidery designs, where you couldn't on the 955. So with this one, say if you wanted a Disney Mickey with the name Mickey on it, you could do it all in one go. Then you've got your shapes. So say if you wanted to make a border on something, you've got all these different styles of borders. So you can do any of those. You've got USB, and then you've also got your memory again. So yeah, that's all the embroidery designs. Okay, so I thought I'd just show you how to thread the machine so we could have a little go at a few of the different sewing side of it. So I'm just going to pop my thread on there, put my spool cap on. So I'm going to wind my bobbin first. So in that hook, around the white part, this is only used for the bobbin as well. So around the peg and then around the back of the disc. So it's really important you get it in that disc because that's your tension disc. So if you don't get it in there properly, then your bobbin's not going to be wound properly. And then what I do is I put it in the little hole and then on there, push that across, and then you're just going to fill it up by pressing the foot control. And once it's done a little bit, you can just cut that off. Again, you've got your speed control there. We'll just fill up a little bit. And then push it back across, pull it off. Thread cutter on the side. And then we're going to thread the needle. So, through that hook still, round the back of the white bit, straight down, back up, right to left, so you don't have to thread that, you just slot it in, and then straight down in the little hook in the little slot, and then number 7. Always make sure your needle's at the highest point. Push that down, it just threads it for you. And then put your bobbin in. Always make sure it's in a P shape. Drop it in around there, down there, and then in the little slot and click it down. Okay, so I thought we would just start by just sewing something out so you can see the quality and you can see the quietness of it. So this is just straightforward, then I can use the thread cutter, thread up. So Okay, so now we're going into the embroidery side of it. What I thought was I'd show you how to change the foot into the embroidery foot. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to unscrew this with a little screwdriver you get. And then I'm going to pop this on. So. Just like that. Okay, so what I'll show you now is how to put the embroidery unit on. So you always switch the machine off and then take this off. So that's also got a little compartment in there as well. And then just slide this on. And it just goes on like that. Okay, so now we've got all the embroidery unit on. All I've put inside here is some stitch and tear and some calico. So you always put your fabric in so it's not like a drum. So you wanna make sure it's inwards, not outwards. And then I'm just gonna lift the foot up, push that under there. And then I'm just gonna put the two little pegs in there and push it down. So that's all set for us to embroider now. Plus I've put bobbin fill, the pre-wound bobbin fills that come in with them in the box, in the bottom, and I've put brother embroidery thread on the top as well, same way as before. And then all I'm going to do is when I'm going to pick my design. I'll just pick this really simple one. Okay, so you can see this is the options you get once you've clicked on the design that you want. So you can click move, you can move it about. So you can change the position on the hoop, and then you've got the size as well. You can't change this one, but you can on the others. You can rotate it, so there's all the different options there. Then you've got your colour changes. There's only one on this one, but if you are wanting, you can pick different colours there. So we're going to be doing it pink, so it doesn't really matter. You've got your delete option, so if you say combined it with something, so you can click add. Just say for instance, okay, so it tells you if it's going to be, so what you can do is make them smaller, so you can do that. You can also move it with your finger, so move that in there, put that on. You can font edit, you can change the different sizes, you can mirror image as well. There's memory there, and then once you've finished, you can just click edit end. And then here you can pinpoint certain positions, so you can see there's a little green cross there now. So that's where it'll be when it starts, and it will also move when it starts embroidering. This is also a little option which is on all embroidery brother machines. So that will go around and it will show you where in the hoop it's going to be positioned. Again, it's memory, you can move it. And that's it, ready to embroider. One other last thing, you've got, when it comes up here, you've got a few different, this is where all your colours will be, so it'll tell you what colours that you've got on here. This is what the first colour, whatever colour you've got on the top, that's where it's going to be positioned there and what it's going to embroider. You've also got the amount of stitches there, you've got how long it's going to take and how many colours you've got. And then if, say, if, for instance, your embroidery thread snapped, and this will go through the stitches as it embroiders, you can go back, forwards on however many stitches you've done. So you can always go back over and do it again if it's snapped. Okay, so now I thought we would just embroider it out. So I've put the foot down, it's all ready, so we're just going to press start. And then what I generally do once it's done a couple is I'm just going to cut this loose thread. So. Thank you. So it cuts the thread and then it'll stop there because that's one colour. So what it'll do now is it's moved to a different colour, which is because I've put Mickey on there. But what I'll do is I'll just do it in the same colour because obviously you don't have to follow the colours if you don't want to. But yeah, this is the next bit. Okay, so now it's finished. So what we'll do is we'll lift the foot up because it'll already have cut it. And then there's a little lever here. And you pull that out. And that's it. Okay, so we've been through everything you get in the box. You do also get a hard case, so obviously we protect it. We've embroidered the design out. We've also gone through the sewing side of it. It is £899 and it's available on our website. As I said, it is very similar to the Innovis 955, but there is a lot more features on this one. Obviously, you've got the colour screen. It is a little bit bigger here and there. You've got the extra long feet in the feed. So yeah, that's everything really. Thank you for watching.